Hello and welcome. Today I'll be going over the basics of Power Stage design using Power Stage Designer. So when you first open up Power Stage Designer, what you should see is what I have on this screen, which is the main page. If I go over and then let's say I want to design with the TPS 7H4001-SP, I can click on the synchronous buck here, because the TPS 7H4001-SP is a synchronous buck. What next will happen is I'll get this page. And so let's say I'm making a 5-to-1 converter at a 500 kHz switching frequency and one about 10% inductor current ripple. Well, I can input my design value. So since I'm designing around 5 volts as the input, I can put in 4 here, 6, have my output voltage of 1, my output current of 18 amps, my switching frequency of 500 kHz, and my inductor current ripple of 10%. Then Power Stage Designer will give me a recommended value for the inductance. So let's put 1 here. Now that I've put a value for the inductance, I can see that over here the current ripple's actually been calculated for me using the chosen value rather than the recommended value, and that's important to know. I can also see what that current ripple looks like by clicking on L1 and having this graph pop up. This will show both the current and the voltage stresses that'll happen to that component. And this is true for any of the components you'll see in yellow. I can also look at it over my input voltage range by taking the slide bar on the top and going left to right, as well as the load current using the bottom slide bar. Note that any of the values you see here will be not including the efficiency that you can expect, and thus should just be seen as nominal values for the circuit design.